My name is Sid Hansen. I used to be a Beverly Hills plastic surgeon. I thought that my life with Jerry was perfect. But after I went home for my sister's wedding, life was never the same. I decided to leave LA. Jerry took it hard. So I returned to Providence, to my family, and an old friend.
Is this the Kyle you used to moon over?
I didn't realize you mooned in high school.
Did you have a cat to declaw? Even dead, Mom still had strong opinions about my life.
You start tearing up the sheets with some limo driver and word will spread like cheap perfume.
Hi, Kyle.
Mom could push more than my buttons. Bye, Kyle.
Mother!
The South Providence boathouse. A romantic, in a rustic sort of way.
Mother, what are you doing here?
I brought you some essentials to spice up your fantasy. Champagne, massage oil, and a nice splinter-proof blanket.
For what?
Don't play innocent. You know very well this was Kyle's former haunt. You can still smell the musk of teenage lust.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Oh, come now. You've been fantasizing about this boy for weeks. You're obviously going to have to get it on with him before you get on with your life.
Oh, no, no, no. Could you just get back in your boat and paddle out of here?
Sid, you in there?
Ready and waiting, Kyle.
Mother, I can take it from here.
Just let me lay out the blanket. Did you bow? Not now, darling. I just want to make sure he knows this is a one-night stand.
Mother! Shove
off! Ah! All around me are all of your hearts. I still don't know how you got me through the bad parts. And then you tell me that even angels fall. Sometimes when it's quiet, call. When I think of your smile, oh, you make me home. It could be a million miles, and you make me home. The sound of your voice, you make me home.
The wash cycle for Krusty's?
Hot wash, warm rinse.
Morning.
Oh, still doesn't know how to do his own laundry?
Hey, Robbie, what's a six-letter word for leg bone?
Kneecap.
Well, that's seven letters.
Fibula. Why are you asking him? I'm the doctor, remember?
How could I forget?
Oh, 15 down is wrong. See, if you make that newt, then 23 across would be igneous.
Hey, Dad.
Morning, Rob.
Do you mind? What is her problem?
Well, it starts with the fact that you do the crosswords in ink and ends with the reality that you'll always be the big sister.
Zoo stories. Isn't this your old partner's column?
Johnson's turned himself into a regular cottage industry. He's more interested in public relations and healthy animals.
Prozac for Pepper. Who's Pepper?
New chimp at the zoo. Not doing well. Public's not happy, so Johnson's dismissing the problem as psychological.
And you think he's wrong?
Well, people are complaining that he's lethargic, that he's chewing on the bars of his enclosure. Obviously, there's something wrong, but it could be any number of things. Psychological problems are the least likely.
So why don't you do something about it? You're still a member of the zoo board, aren't you?
I haven't been into a meeting since Johnson took over.
Dad, you can't let your personal feelings for old Dick get in the way. I mean, I think it would be really good for you to get more involved at the zoo.
Maybe you're right. I suppose I could take a run over there during lunch.
You can't do any harm. Okay. Kyle.
Hey.
What are you doing here?
I had an early morning run up to Boston. Brought you some of the best donuts on the East Coast.
That's sweet. Thanks.
Can I carry those?
Sure. Ow. Oh. Ow. Shoulder?
Bad rotator cuff.
Yeah, I remember. You want me to take a look at it?
No, it's okay. It's chronic.
Come on, let me take a look at it. At the very least, I can get rid of some of that pain for you.
Well, if you don't mind.
Not at all. Why don't you come by my house after work, and I'll give you a shot.
A shot?
I give great injection.
I'll bet you do.
Beverly Hills, California. What do we have here?
It's marked personal and confidential, Robbie.
Sue? Oh, come on. This could be our big chance to get a glimpse into the sordid, private L.A. life of our older sister.
What are you talking about?
Oh, come on. You didn't buy that plastic surgery bit, did you? I think she's running an upscale escort service.
In your dreams. It's probably testimonials from her old patients begging her to come back and make their lives whole again.
Yeah, well, you're probably right, but gotta be better than advances in canine hip dysplasia.
It's your favorite time of year in Malibu. LA's never been more alive. Come on! I want you to meet my latest client and my new best friend. Here's Howie.
Hi.
Sid, life's a beach.
My new agent, Jerry, wanted me to have a heart-to-heart with you. I mean, after all, we have a lot in common. You're a real doctor. I played one on TV.
Wow.
You brought the library.
Yeah, well, I was a little rusty on peds, OBGYN, GI, and everything else for that matter.
Family medicine is mostly psychology and common sense.
Yeah, well, I brush up on that at home.
Watch yourself with that one. She's a charter member of our turkey file.
You keep a turkey file?
Yeah. Keeps you from getting roasted. Here. Migraine, back pain, toothache, anything for drugs.
Darla Owens.
You know her?
If it's the same girl, she was really good friends with Joni in high school.
Do your sister a favor. Keep this one to yourself.
Hey, Darla, I'm Sid.
Who?
Sid Hansen, Joni's sister.
I've never heard of her.
You and Joni were attached at the hip. Every time I came home from college, you were at my house.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You were on the field hockey team together. You went to state semis. Your sister Tracy was a year ahead of me in school.
I don't have a sister. So maybe we can skip the trip down memory lane and you can help me out here.
Must have made a mistake. Have a seat. What seems to be the problem?
I got a killer migraine.
Well, what did Doc Reynolds give you in the past?
Demerol.
Demerol, huh? You tried Imitrax?
It makes me hurl.
DHE?
I'm allergic to it.
Narcotics aren't gonna help.
Are you gonna give me a shot of Demerol or am I out of here?
I'm gonna give you a low dose so you can relax while I order some blood tests.
I need 200 milligrams, minimum.
Yeah, well, we're gonna start slowly, so why don't you lay back and relax and I'll have the nurse come in.
Pepper. Pepper. Pepper.
Hey, Jim. Did you get a chance to read the new book I sent you?
I haven't finished the first one yet, but I did manage to catch your column today.
You know, visitors have been wondering why he's acting weird. I want to set their minds at ease.
At Pepper's expense? He doesn't look good to me.
I checked him out. You know, people like to hear that chimps have the same adjustment problems as you and me.
You always tell them what they like to hear. Dick, he's been in there a month and he's getting worse. Those pigeons? Their droppings are a natural reservoir for cryptococcus. Did you check him for meningitis?
When I hear hoofbeats, I think horses, not zebras.
And when I hear about a patient that's not getting better, I think maybe the doctor missed his diagnosis.
Are you calling my professional competency into question?
I'm suggesting a second opinion.
All right, Jimbo, look, I tell you what I'll do. I will get a few board members together, informally, and we can meet in my office.
When?
Will tonight be all right, or do you want me to drop everything else I'm doing?
Tonight. No later.
All right, call my secretary to get a time.
Darla, wake up.
What? Hey, I was resting my eyes.
Your white blood count was really low. If this rash on your face is shingles, there may be an underlying medical problem.
My head's still killing me. I need more Demerol.
Well, you can't be in that much pain. You were just passed out. Your drug screen came back positive for opiates, alcohol, and cocaine.
Not me, Ma. I was at the library.
Come on, get up. I need to examine your eye with this lit lamp. Have a seat. Want to tilt your head back for me? This could sting.
Ow, damn.
Have you noticed any weight loss, other skin irritations, cough, or vaginal discharge?
No.
How's it going, Darla?
Like you give a rat's ass.
Just put your chin right here.
Ow.
Sorry.
Damn it. Can I get somebody who knows what they're doing?
Why don't I...
I don't want you touching me.
Then you're out of options, Darla.
Bitch.
Darla. Sit down. You have an eye infection which could cause blindness.
How do you know? You can't even work the machine.
This can also be a sign of a serious underlying illness.
I'm not sick.
Darla. Darla, these are track marks. How can you be so sure?
Get off of me!
You got lucky. No septal hematoma.
Oh.
And the x-rays are negative.
Oh, go ahead, say it. I told you so.
It's not about me being right and you being wrong, Sid. I've just been here longer.
Oh, okay, well, you got my number, not to mention Darla's.
I've seen her when she couldn't even remember her name.
Oh, sad.
Yeah. Listen, go home and change your blouse. I'll hold down the fort.
Thanks. Ah. Dr. Hansen?
Yeah?
Kyle Moran called, said he'll be by your house at 6:30. Terrific.
Joni, have you seen my hip dysplasia tape?
Yeah, it's in the VCR.
Oh. Thanks. Would you please call Dick Johnson's office? Find out what time we're meeting tonight.
Mm-hmm. Now, here in L.A., you're not just a surgeon. You're an artist. Now, this is a palette. You can create a smile where there was a cleft palate. Give us 10 more years of Meg Ryan movies. These are worthy contributions, Sid.
Dad? I've got Johnson's secretary on the phone. She said the meeting's 8 o'clock Tuesday night.
Tuesday? No, no, no. That meeting has to be tonight. Tuesday's too late. I'll talk to her myself. Hi, this is Dr. Hansen. I was promised a meeting tonight. Uh-huh. Well, when did this previous engagement come up? Sorry, would you just put Dick on the line? Oh, really? You tell him this is not acceptable. And please, be sure you tell him that. Thank you.
Wow, what happened to you?
I got punched in the nose by an old friend of yours.
Of mine? Who?
Darla Owens.
You're kidding.
I wish. She came into the clinic high as a kite looking for Demerol. She had track marks running up and down her arms.
Darla? I mean, she was always a little wild, but, God, I find that hard to believe.
How long has it been since you've seen her?
A couple years ago. We kind of lost touch when I started dating Richie. Why'd she hit you?
Because I suggested that she might have AIDS.
She doesn't, does she?
Who knows? She took off before I could test her.
What are you gonna do?
What can I do? I mean, she clearly doesn't want my help.
Maybe she just didn't feel she could ask for it, particularly from somebody like you.
Why do you do that? Particularly from somebody like me? What is that supposed to mean?
You're just a lot like her sister, Tracy. you know, miss all everything. You probably made her feel like a complete loser.
I did not.
Ugh, like you'd ever be aware of it.
Here you go. Okay.
Thanks, Tom.
All right.
Hey, Dad. Lemonade, no ice.
Not today. Can I have a word with you in private?
Yeah, sure. Something wrong?
Mm-hmm. Big time.
Okay, let's go outside.
Word is you can keep your mouth shut.
Yeah, sure, sole discretion. What do you need?
Some of your skills.
Eating and sleeping?
Aiding and abetting.
Dad, how could you think of your own son that way?
Because I'm the one who bailed you out twice.
Fair enough. So what's up?
Listen, Rob, I'm paying a little visit to the zoo tonight.
I didn't know the zoo was open at night.
It's not. There's an animal there that may be in trouble. And you know what they say, when the going gets tough.
The tough go to the zoo?
Exactly.
Are you saying that you want to break into the zoo and you're asking for my help?
Yes, son, I am.
You can count on me. Well, night break-in is going to require some gear. Night vision glasses, wire cutters, fake IDs.
We won't need any of that.
We don't?
Not with this.
Did you send Darla Owen's blood out for a CD4 count?
Sure, the lab picks up in 10 minutes.
Ask them to fax me at home with the results.
Okay.
Thanks.
CD4 count?
I can't do an HIV test without her permission. At least I can get an indirect confirmation.
First of all, it's unethical. Second of all, who's going to pay for it?
I will.
Are you letting your personal feelings dictate how you take care of patients?
Are you?
All right. Do the test.
Hi.
What happened to you?
Well, one of my patients went postal. It's nothing, really. Come on in. Here.
Oh, no, I don't need that. Unless you want me to.
Oh, no, I just thought, you know, I've seen plenty of male torsos in my time.
Seen one, you've seen them all, huh?
Yeah. Guess this shoulder's giving you quite a problem.
How's that?
Well, I had to put a crimp in your rowing.
My rowing? No, I haven't been in a skull since high school when I...
That's right. Does that hurt?
Yeah. Especially when I do this. Ow!
Oh! Don't do that. You definitely have rotator cuff tendonitis. Mm. You know, I'm going to give you an injection of Marcaine and cortisone. And that should get you rowing in no time.
Sid, is there, something about rowing I should know?
No, I just thought you might want to have that option. There we go. Okay, want to hold that right there?
Yeah, thanks. Now what?
Well, now... I ask you out to dinner tonight. You pick your favorite place.
I meant my shoulder.
Oh, I recommend physical therapy.
For my rowing?
No, for your regular life. Mm. You never know what you're gonna need to do with that arm.
You're right. Most of the time I haven't been able to get it up to here.
Really?
Really. You made me a new man, Doc.
I see the doctor's in.
Hi.
Don't mind me.
By the way, I'd love to have dinner tonight.
Great. Why don't you just come back around 9?
Okay.
security's on rounds. We have 8 minutes.
Okay, let's synchronize our watches. All right, now we got 7. All right, you need all the keys. What do you need me for?
Emergencies. Do your thing. Oh, oh, oh. I'm impressed. I don't know if I should be.
Pepper.
There he is. Hi, Pepper. Remember me? Brought you something. Hmm? Good, huh? How you feeling? Let's see. Yeah, not feeling so good, huh? Look what I've got here. Hmm? Like that? Okay, okay, come on.
How's he doing?
Not good. Let's go.
Let's go?
I thought you were treating him here.
To work him up back at the office.
He's zoo property, that's grand larceny. Now you got the keys, so I can skate around breaking and entering, but with my priors, you know, grand larceny could get me 5 to 10.
He's not property.
He's a monkey, Dad.
He's not a monkey, he's a chimp. Genetically, he's 99% human. As far as I'm concerned, he should have the same constitutional rights you do.
Yeah, well, if you believe that, then it's felony kidnapping and we both go to prison.
They can kill you, but they can't eat you.
You asked him out. That's taking the bull by the horns.
It's just dinner, Mother.
Oh, honey, the funeral is over. It wouldn't kill you to wear pastel. You have to be a little more seductive. Have you considered a wonder bra?
Well, this is one.
Oh. This'll work? With a pair of high heels?
I'm wearing comfortable shoes.
Oh.
The stretch limo would be a nice touch if he weren't the one driving it.
I don't care what Kyle does for a living. I mean, we're just going out for a nice dinner and to catch up on each other's lives.
All the same, condoms are a good idea.
Kyle's here. Your patient is back for a more thorough examination.
Kyle. Oh, my God.
Oh. What happened with Darla? Did she ever come back?
No, Joni, she didn't.
So that's it? She's off your radar screen?
Well, I did order a test that would determine her CD4 count.
What good is that gonna do?
If it's low, it would suggest that she has AIDS, and hopefully it'll convince her to get a test.
Assuming you know where to find her.
Look, Joni, the results are gonna be faxed to the house. If it's bad, we'll deal with it tomorrow.
Right. You have a big date tonight.
You know, I can't win with you, so I'm not gonna even try. Excuse me.
Wow. You're beautiful.
Wow. I'm overdressed.
No, you look great. Providence could use a little Hollywood glamour. And I see your nose is better.
Yes, much better. How's your shoulder?
Better too. Everything's better.
Great. So where are we going?
My favorite place, O'Neill's Bar.
Great. We can see Robbie in action.
Oh, well, we could go someplace else.
No, that's fine. Mine in Providence.
Great.
Can we hurry up before someone sees us? How's that?
Perfect. I think he likes you.
Yeah?
Just you and me, Hansky Pansky. What'll it be? Cartoon Network or Springer?
1 is the loneliest number you can ever do. Sure, I screwed up. But don't forget the times we shared together. Baby, I need you like the flowers need the rain.
You've gotta be kidding me.
So come back home, Sid. And when you do, check out the old crow's feet. And also my new talk show. She's the only one that doesn't need a facelift.
Oh my God. Hi, yeah. Do you have a listing for Owens? Darla?
He comes too, and he's peeking out the ear hole of his helmet, and I am 90 yards downfield with the TV.
I actually went to that game.
You saw that run?
No, I had to leave early. I had an AP biology test the next day. But I spent a lot of time watching at group practice, though. I love the boathouse. It's beautiful. I used to study there all the time.
How about we go there and I'll take you out for a ride?
What made you think of that?
I'll check the spinal fluid and we'll have a diagnosis. Is he waking up yet?
Nope. Still 4 claws to the sky.
Try stimulating him.
No, thanks. I've breathed enough monkey fumes.
He's not a monkey. He's a chimp.
Okay, chimp fumes. Meanwhile, Dad, you about done?
Mm-hmm. All I have to do is check for capsules and we'll have our diagnosis.
What?
No capsules.
Negative for cryptococcus.
Was that good or bad?
No meningitis, good for him. I was wrong, bad for us.
Oh. In case you get chilly.
Your letterman's jacket.
Does it reek of mothballs?
No, it smells great. Well? Locked.
Oh, no problem. Okay, there it is. Take a second. You ever been inside?
In my dreams. I mean, I've always wanted to. Oh. You're caught. Should have worn more comfortable shoes.
No, you shouldn't have. I'm gonna grab a skull. I can't wait to get back on the water.
Watch your shoulder.
It's fine. Ow! Ow!
Oh my God! Kyle!
Sorry to interrupt. I'm Joni Hansen. I'm an old friend of your sister Darla's.
Yes?
You probably don't remember me. You were in college.
Well, actually, I'm right in the middle of class. What is it you wanted?
Darla might be in some trouble.
What else is new? Look, I'm fresh out of rescues. I've been to all the ERs, police stations, crash pads, and all she's ever done is resent me for it.
Oh, that's not true. She always looked up to you. All she ever did was talk about your RISD scholarship and about how you were dating Jeff, Mr. Cool Harding.
Yeah, well, that was the yearbook version of my life. Right now, I'm a single mother. I teach art at night. I have to struggle just like everybody else, and I wish that she could see that.
It's hard when your older sister's the star of the family. Believe me, I know. But right now she's sick and she needs some treatment.
Well, she made the choice. Living on the street, shooting drugs. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Darla might have AIDS.
It's been great reliving my glory days with you, Sid, but I don't know exactly how to put this.
Just put it. It's always the best.
Sid, I feel like I've been trapped in some weird high school fantasy.
Yeah. Mine.
Question is, where do we go from here?
Maybe we could take a shot at a grown-up relationship.
Not tonight, dear. I have a headache.
Normal white count. Lights, glucose, spinal tap.
What do we do now? We got a limp chimp here. Pepper, 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 pepper. Oh, man, this gas is killing me.
Of course. Of course, gas. Gas. Gas, gas, gas. Bingo. Diarrhea and flatulence, encephalitis, peripheral neuritis, and anemia. He's got lead poisoning. Where's that urine?
Acetic acid, ether, my Woods lamp's in the drawer.
Woods lamp?
Black light.
Let's see. Get the proper mix here.
Wow.
Yeah.
Are you a deadhead?
If this thing turns as red as scarlet begonias, we're trucking. Hit the lights, will you?
Sure.
Robbie, my boy, you're a genius.
Day glow urine. Far out.
EDTA. Running in wide open.
Smell gas. Is the pilot light? Oh, my God. Tell me this is not Pepper.
It is, and he's got lead poisoning, which we know thanks to Robbie.
Robbie?
What, that's so unbelievable? Oh, let me guess. Underwater high school reunion.
Funny. Dad, you could go to jail. You could lose your license. This animal needs to go back to the zoo.
Not till we get the lead out.
When I said to get involved, I did not mean in Grand Theft Monkey.
He's a chimp.
Whatever. Isn't this your third strike or something?
There's no such thing in Rhode Island. I don't think.
This is all my fault.
Don't be silly. I appreciate the wake-up call.
You know what? We actually got it all under control here, sis, so why don't you go ahead and watch that video Jerry sent you?
Jerry sent me a video?
I told you.
No, you didn't.
It's like a Jerry infomercial with Howie Mandel.
Perfect. Darla. Hey, it's me, Joni.
Long time.
Yeah. I'm sorry we lost touch, but I got pregnant and, you know. I have a baby now.
Oh, great.
Wow, it seems like a gazillion years since high school. Remember that bus ride to the semifinals when you and I were like...
High school's over, Joni. How'd you find me?
I ran into your sister, Tracy. I think she's worried about you.
Well, I'm surprised she's not here. Making sure I have a place to crash.
Speaking of big sisters, I hear you ran into mine.
Ah, you could say that.
Look, she ran a blood test on you, a CD something. It's supposed to show you...
I told her I don't have AIDS.
Darla, I'm not a doctor. But I think you should go back and see my sister.
Like you said, you're not a doctor. Go home, Joni. Go take care of your baby.
I wish there were a logical explanation. I wasn't in touch with my own feelings.
Hey, Robbie. You know where Joni and Hannah are?
It's me. Hey, check this out.
I was afraid, so I pushed you away. Try and find it in your heart to reach out to me.
Hey, come on. Don't you want to see this?
No. Thank you very much. Oh, great. That's probably the SWAT team.
But they don't ring the bell. Hey, come on. Don't answer it.
I'm not going to be arrested as an accomplice to larceny.
Kidnapping.
And this somehow comforts you?
I know he's got Pepper in here.
Dr. Johnson, I'm a big fan of your radio show.
Don't blow hot air in my shorts. He's downstairs, isn't he?
You are feeling better, aren't you, guy?
Oh, my God. Hi. Look at you.
Now, out of respect for Linda's memory, I'll keep the police out of this and just take the chimp back.
What you should do is thank him for saving your butt.
What are you talking about?
Lead poisoning? Never did acid wash that new enclosure, did you? He's been chewing on the bars, ingesting lead from the solder.
Says who?
His urine's positive. He's also got gasophilic stippling.
Gasophilic.
What he said of the red cells.
It's a simple test. Look for yourself.
I tell you what, I will take the chimp back to the zoo and we'll forget this ever happened.
Thank you, Dr. Johnson.
Chimp stays here.
What?
What?
Unless you agree to acid wash that enclosure.
Yeah, and could you get him some chimp buddies, please?
Put in some trees they can brachiate through.
And who's gonna pay for all this?
You are.
And if you don't, I guess we're gonna have to go public.
The zoo association might yank your accreditation.
And the animal activists are gonna eat you alive.
Why don't you and I sit down on Monday and, go through the discretionary budget, see what we can squeeze out.
Hey, where the hell have you been? I've been worried sick.
I went to Talbert's Wharf.
You took the baby down there this time of night?
Of course not. I dropped her with Ms. Maravich.
What were you doing down there?
I went to see Darla. Her CD4 count came back. I tried to get her sister Tracy to help, but she wouldn't. And neither would you, so I had to.
Wait a minute. Please tell me you did not give her the results of that test. Did you?
Sort of.
Oh, damn it, Joni! It's illegal to give a patient an AIDS test without their permission. I went out on a limb doing that test. You've put me and the clinic at legal risk.
I'm sorry. You seem more interested in your dream date.
You have no idea what's going on inside me.
That's because you keep it a big secret. I learned more about your life from Jerry's stupid video than I ever did from you.
Where's Darla?
$5 Dewey's. I was only trying to help, Sid.
Okay, come on.
In you go, boy.
Where are you taking him?
To the infirmary.
He's gonna be okay?
He'll be fine, son. I'm sure Dr. Johnson will see to that.
Hey, I'll come see you, big guy.
Okay. Let's go.
Darla, I need to talk to you.
Leave me alone.
Joni? Sid.
Hi.
Hi.
Your sister came by.
I know. I'm sorry. She shouldn't have done that.
I couldn't get what she said out of my head.
Joni has that effect.
Must be nice to have a sister like her.
Yeah. A few hours ago, we wanted to kill each other.
Those annoying little sisters.
Those overbearing big sisters.
So, where is Darla?
She's over here.
If I can bring her to the clinic in the morning, can you see her?
Of course.
Hey, sis. You look cold.
I'm freezing.
I can't sleep. Oh, I'm sorry I screwed things up with Darla. Actually, you didn't. I went to go find her, and her sister Tracy showed up, took her home.
Wow. What happened?
You know how it is with big sisters. They can be so self-centered that sometimes they lose sight of the fact that there might be a different way to do things. Unless, of course, they're lucky enough to have a kid sister who gives them a wake-up call.
Well, those big sisters can surprise you now and then. When they're not being incredibly self-centered and...
Watch it. I know sometimes you think I must hate you. But for the record, when I think about who I want Hannah to be like when she grows up, it's you, not me.
Yay.
Well, let's just hope the kid gets the best of both of us, okay?
Yeah. Wanna come under? You mind giving me some room here?
Oh, you mind giving me some covers?
Oh. Your feet are like ice.
My feet? Oh, ow!
In a meeting.